Today on Studio One, Glenn Danzig has been on the cutting edge of rock music for more than 20 years. We sat down with him to discuss his many other projects. Also, hunters and anglers often tell stories of the one that got away. We'll see how taxidermy can preserve memories and also help with catch-and-release fishing. And U-571 is a World War II movie that takes place underwater. We'll take a peek at Matthew McConaughey's latest movie.
From the University of North Dakota, with Monty Cashel and Rachel Glock, this is Studio One.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to Studio One.
Thanks for joining us today.
Well, the Sydney Olympics are coming up pretty soon.
This summer, is that it?
That's right, 2000, okay. and the torch is all ready to go, mm-hmm. And the torch is going to be all over the place. It's the longest torch run ever.
Oh, wow.
It's going up into space, up on a shuttle.
Really?
It's also going underwater near the Great Barrier Reef.
Uh-huh.
And it's also going to be transported by camel and solar-powered car.
Interesting. So technology-driven.
Yep. I don't know how they're going to do it underwater, but I'm sure it'll be interesting.
Yeah, no
kidding. We'll find out.
Yeah.
We've got a great show for you today. Many kids go to a summer camp. Camp Good Morning is a special camp which offers friendship, games, and also teaches how to deal with feelings of sadness. Later in the show, we'll talk with someone who has been involved in the summer camp since it began.
And a landscape artist is an expert in enhancing the beauty of man-made structures through a skillful blending of natural resources. Later, we'll share some landscaping tips with you.
But first, today's news with Kelly Franson.
Thank you, Monty and Rachel. A teacher and four students were stabbed at an Ottawa high school early this morning by a 15-year-old male student using a kitchen knife. None of the victim's wounds were life-threatening. The incident began with a dispute outside the school library, then moved into a computer lab. The principal talked the student into giving up his knife.
I was at my locker. He comes by. He's got kind of looked like ketchup almost, right? I thought he was joking. He's like, yeah, sure. But he turns out his neck's all bleeding. I'm like, oh my gosh.
While residents in Ottawa face the reality of school violence, another community remembers the victims of its own tragedy. Classes at Columbine High School were canceled today. A moment of silence observed at 11:21 a.m. marked the same time gunfire echoed through the halls of the school last year. A morning assembly was held for students, but some chose to stay away from the school and the terrible memories. An Illinois carpenter who erected memorial crosses last year brought them back to restore the tribute. A candlelight vigil will be held at nearby Clement Park tonight. For years, researchers have said that a glass of wine a day can help decrease the risk of heart disease. But a recent study at the University of Wisconsin Medical School says that you can get the same benefits without the alcohol. Purple grape juice was found to have the same benefits as red wine. Both grape juice and red wine have a substance called flavonoids. These disease-fighting antioxidants are believed to prevent blood from clumping together and damaging the blood vessels. Orange juice and grapefruit juice contain flavonoids as well, but they are not as effective as purple grape juice.
The reason they push more towards the purple grape juice is in the process of making that grape juice is it crushes the skins, the flesh or the meat of the grape, as well as the seeds. Where if you just eat the grapes, most people will spit the seeds out.
Doctors say an advantage of switching from wine to a glass of purple grape juice a day is that there is no problem with driving afterwards. Wired-up seals, dolphins, and a whale may have the answer to a puzzling question. For years, scientists have wondered how marine mammals dive to the bottom without running out of air. It turns out they let gravity do most of the work. By attaching video cameras to the animals' backs, a team of biologists learn that ocean mammals glide most of the way down with their lungs compressed. This helps them conserve oxygen. One biologist says they are turning their motors off in the dive. This helps them reduce oxygen consumption by 10 to 15% compared to what they would need if they swam the entire way down. The economy is doing well, but that has many educators worried. They fear that as a result, today's teenagers are not concerned with investing and won't be financially prepared for the future.
The media is filled with reassuring financial news, and our growing economy shows a promising future for investors. But the future may not be as bright for some of today's teens. Studies show that many high school seniors lack knowledge about money management, investing, and saving.
Right now, we're in a positive economy. So the kids are thinking that, you know, basically money does grow on trees and they can go and buy, but it isn't that case.
With all the media attention on the stock market, some experts say they would expect students to be more interested in personal finance. But in a multiple choice exam on personal finance, high school seniors on average answered only 52% of the questions correctly. That's down from 3 years ago when the average score was 57%. Based on a typical grading scale, this is a failing grade. Some experts believe the scores could be improved if schools were to focus more on teaching students early on about personal finance and economics. Ball says parents should also help educate their children.
If all the parents would sit down and talk to their, sons and daughters about, what they are doing and how they're budgeting and some of their struggles they've gone through, then I think things would a little bit be better.
Experts say that if teens are not well informed about finances, they become vulnerable. They'll make unwise investments and take on far more debt than they can handle in the future. I'm Kristen Reckadal reporting for Studio One News.
In the national survey, less than one-fourth of the students knew that stocks would most likely offer the highest growth over 18 years, rather than a savings account. I'll have more news for you later in the show, but right now, more with Monty and Rachel.
Thanks a lot, Kelly. Well, I'm sure there will be a flood of high school students running to get jobs for summer coming up here pretty soon.
You're probably right, but let's hope there isn't a real flood. But let's go now to the Regional Weather Information Center with Eric Svoboda for our weather. Eric?
Well, Monty and Rachel, I'm sure a lot of high schoolers would rather get out and just enjoy these nice conditions rather than having to grudge through getting a job. Let's take a look at those current conditions in the Grand Forks area right now. We're at a temperature of 62 right now in the Grand Forks area, dew point of 20, winds slight out of the north, and that pressure is falling. If you look at temperatures across the region, you can see Regina is the high spot at 72 and some mid-50s to low 60s for much of the region. The reason for these cooler temperatures off to our east is that low pressure pushed through and dropped some rain and some rain-snow mix in the early part of the day today, but that's pushed off to the east. We're under high pressure, and through the evening right now into tomorrow morning, we're going to remain under high pressure and clear skies. It's going to be a great day tomorrow, except for off to the east on the Ohio River Valley, they're looking at some rain and chance of some thunderstorms in Friday morning. Friday evening looks much the same for us, so we're going to be under a great day. All day long, that sun's going to get out and warm up the temperatures. Let's take a look at those temperatures. Friday's lows dropping down to 30s, but then for Friday's highs, it's going to get really warm, 60s for our region, and down to the south and west, some 70s sneaking in. Saturday's lows just dipping down to the 40s for much of our region, for places like Grand Forks and Mora. And for Saturday's high temperatures, jumping back up to the 60s and 70s for parts of South Dakota. For all of your up-to-date weather information, please log on to our homepage at www.rwic.und.edu. So, Monty and Rachel, Friday's going to be a great day to get out and maybe do some spring cleaning, although I'm sure a lot of people would rather just get out and take a walk and enjoy the nice weather.
All right. Thanks, Eric.
That'll be good. I'm breaking out the barbecue.
All right. Let me know when you're doing that. I'll come
over. Well, I hate to mention ice, but it's in a good way. We've got Brian Sean with NHL Highlights.
Thank you, Monty and Rachel. The NHL playoffs are in full swing, and with the playoffs come upsets. One series that has been particularly surprising thus far has been the Pittsburgh Penguins and Washington Capitals series. The 7-seed Pittsburgh came into Wednesday night up 3-1 over the 2nd-seeded Capitals. To the highlights we go. First period game tied at 1 until Jaromir Jagr beats Oleg Polzog on the wraparound. Penguins up a goal. Now to the third game tied at 2. And tempers start flaring as Richard Zednik hacks Ron Tugnut, and the Tugger not going to take it, slashes him right back, and he would get a penalty on that. That penalty led to the Caps' power play, where a shot would go in front, and on the rebound, Jeff Halpern scores, and Washington stays alive and wins 3-2. To the NBA, Denver at Portland. Fourth quarter, Portland up 1, as you see some fans right there, and taken away there by Bonzi Well, takes away from Leifer French, who throws it up court to Stacey Ogden, who finishes it off, and Stacey's pretty happy about it, and these kids' parents would be very proud of themselves. Now back to the ball game. Nick Van Exel with 5 seconds left gets it and fires it, and ball game. And Denver wins this one 96-95. Van Exel skipping along. To baseball, San Francisco at Cincinnati. Ken Griffey Jr. and Barry Bonds with a few courtesies before the game, and on to baseball. Top of 2, Giants up 2-0, and Ryan Bell don't pitch it right there, because Ramon Martinez just takes him deep, 3-0 Giants. But the Reds would come back in the bottom of the inning, down 3-2, and up to bat, Benito Santiago just took Sean Estes deep, and that's a two-run shot. Cincinnati hangs on for the 5-4 win. Ever since he strapped on a pair of goalie pads, North Dakota junior Carl Gehring has been told he's too small to excel. But now the 5'7", 150-pound goalie will have a chance to test his skills at hockey's highest level against the top teams from 16 countries. He has been selected to play for the U.S. national team in the 2000 International Hockey Federation's World Championships in St. Petersburg, Russia. Fighting Sioux head coach Dean Blaze, who will be an assistant coach on the team, says there is a reason why Gehring was the only college underclassman named to the team.
I felt that with what Carl has done and what he's done in the past and all his stats and, you know, very outstanding performance in the national tournament, that he was the best goaltender available.
Gehring stopped 51 of 53 shots in two games at the NCAA Frozen Four, and his 1.89 goals against average this season was the second lowest in school history. And now it's time for the Studio One Sports Trivia Question of the Week. This week's question: in Major League Baseball, which league has more All-Star Game wins, the National League or the American League? I'll answer that more in the second half hour of sports, but first, here's Monty and Rachel.
All right, thanks, Brian. A hospital in Grand Forks, North Dakota has started a summer camp that focuses on a child's perspective of both life and death. The director of Camp Good Morning, spelled M-O-U-R-N-I-N-G, will tell us how grieving children benefit from this weekend getaway.
You're watching the 25th season of Studio One. Celebrate Silver is our theme. Here's a silver moment, a moment in time, with a special guest.
I think discipline's a beautiful word. I think it gives you freedom. Everybody's talking about freedom. I don't think you can have freedom until you have some discipline in your life.
We're a very smart family. We wanted a warm house, a cozy fire, hot dogs on the grill, lots of hot water, and saving money. So we chose natural gas from NSP, the wise energy choice.
Columbia Mall in Grand Forks has been a cornerstone of the Grand Forks economy for over 20 years. Meet me at Columbia is a slogan that has seen friends and neighbors gathering at Columbia Mall. Three main anchors with 80 specialty stores and shops greets customers daily, Monday through Sunday, featuring the very latest in goods and services at the most competitive prices. Shop Target, JCPenney, and Dayton's, along with the specialty stores in climate-controlled comfort, no matter what the season. A continuing leader and community cornerstone is Columbia Mall, Grand Forks.
Welcome the sun with 35 Sunblock. The way the best water now mostly comes in bottles. It's the way we make time for exercise and like to enjoy reading. Today, more and more people are finding reasons to live healthier. That's why Subway offers 7 subs, each under 6 grams of fat. Because when you're through surfing, you might want to put on a bathing suit. Subway, it's the way a sandwich should be.
This is Studio One's 25th season. Thanks for joining us as we celebrate Silver.
Dealing with the death of a loved one is difficult for many, especially children. All True Hospital in Grand Forks, North Dakota has created a summer camp for kids ages 5 to 16 who have lost a loved one in their lives. Camp Good Morning director Linda Eikman is here to tell us about the camp, her role as director, and how people can get involved. Thank you for coming on the show today.
Well, thank you very much for having me, Monty.
Well, it sounds like a great camp. And what is the purpose of it?
Well, the purpose probably is obvious in what it's called. It's a kids' grief camp. And we felt a real need to have something like this for kids because I think kids tend to be the ones that are ignored when it comes time for a tragedy and dealing with the tragedy. And I felt that it was time to start helping our kids deal with those things because actually 85% of kids who are incarcerated have had some kind of loss in their life. So what we did was we just decided to help kids in some way, in some fun way, help them understand how they're going to cope with that loss. And the way we say that is we don't get over losses, we learn to move through our losses. And so all we do is help the kids help each other. I don't help them deal with their loss, they help each other. And that's the point of the camp and our support groups is you're with your peers helping each other.
Well, how did this all get started then?
Well, that's a very good question, because I think it's important that I recognize how that happened. I actually had a 15-year-old girl come to me once and say, Linda, I need help. No one in the community is an expert at this, and everyone that I try to go to for help doesn't know how to help me. And I thought, a 15-year-old girl is coming and asking for help, and I thought it was time that All True do something, because we do have the expertise. I'm a hospice social worker, so I deal with grief and death and dying every day. So we started with a group and just inviting kids to come and be there for each other, and it went fantastically. So we decided, after 6 years of success, we thought we'd try a camp. And so we did in 1998, and it's just been a great smashing success.
And it sounds like it's important to have a lot of teamwork going involved in this, and I know, talking to you earlier, it's a lot of one-on-one. That's what you like to have.
Yep. I'm just the one who throws it all together, and I could not do the camp, and All True could not do this camp without volunteers. Every staff person that works this camp is a volunteer. So that's what I'm doing in the process of right now, is training 40 volunteers to be there for the kids. And they're all there because they want to be and want to help those kids. And many of those volunteers have had a loss themselves. Mm-hmm. So they're thinking back to their childhood. I think I could give back and help kids. And so we just train them.
Well, what is a typical day at the camp? Go through it with us.
It's typical in that it's typical camp stuff, where there's fun, there's a water slide, we have relay races. But what's different about this camp is we focus on the death, but we incorporate support group facilitating with helping them cope with those different feelings, talk about it, use each other, cry, be sad, be happy, and then go have fun. And then have fun with each other, but yet everything we do is therapeutic. Even the activities the kids do are in relationship to their loss.
Well, what are some of the activities that they do to get over their grief?
Well, we do lots of different things, including activity. We want the kids, it's camp, and we want them to be tired at 11 o'clock at night, so we do lots of races and swimming and water slides, but there's also art therapy. And what we do is we have a special barn that's just created for that, with lots of crafts. They don't know they're doing therapy, but they're doing something that has to do with a memory.
Okay, and we have some pictures,
yep.
Sorry to interrupt, but
yep.
We do have some pictures
That'd
from
be great.
The camp. And if you could just explain what those pictures are.
Kids can do so much in art. It's hard for children to express verbally like you and I can, because they don't have the expertise. So what we do is we have them draw, and they can come up with things drawing that they would never be able to think of saying. So the picture that you're seeing right now is what we asked one of our teenagers to draw, a picture of life and what she sees life as. And this is also a picture here of what she sees death as. And what she explained it as is, death to her is a crack in her heart,
mm-hmm.
and it's, as you can see, it's crying.
Okay.
And so she would probably never be able to say that.
Right.
The next visual that I think you have is of a child who we've asked to also explain what he feels life is. Now, remember, he had a brother that just died in a fire. So you can't imagine that they would have any positive aspects of life. What he's drawn there is a rainbow, and at the end of the rainbow, if you can see, it's a pot full of happy faces.
Mm-hmm.
So he would never, again, be able to tell me that, but on paper he can. Then we ask him to draw death, and he has a picture of his brother in a grave, but he also has him and his brother communicating, and you look at the colors and how he's picturing blue, and he has yellow there for heaven. So all those things mean something. He may not know it,
mm-hmm.
but we know it in helping him process that.
Okay. Well, it looks like a really interesting camp, and the kids must get a lot out of it. We've run out of time,
okay.
But thank you for sharing
the
story
dates,
with us.
Can I say the dates?
Sure.
June 9th, 10th, and 11th, and give me a call at All True if you're interested in attending.
Okay. All True Hospital in Grand Forks,
yep.
North Dakota. Thanks a lot for coming
Thanks,
on the show.
Thanks, Monty, very much.
The United States attempts to board a German U-boat in the new movie U-571. We'll preview the film next. But first, preserving an animal sometimes means saving a memory. We'll see why when we spend a day in the life of a taxidermist. That's next. Stay with us.
The University of North Dakota's Division of Continuing Education can help you learn throughout your lifetime. Begin or continue your education through correspondence study, extended degree programs, and extension courses. For your personal or professional growth, we offer conferences as well as courses in dietary management and real estate.
We invite you to contact us at the Division of Continuing Education to discuss your learning opportunities.
Call us or look us up on the World Wide Web. The University of North Dakota has a rich history of retaining and graduating American Indian students. UND offers 28 American Indian programs, more than any other higher education institution in the U.S. The support services provided by Native American programs enhance student success. Native American programs offer tutoring, academic advising, and financial aid assistance, which makes UND a leader in Indian education. For more information, call 1-800-CALL-UND. That's 1-800-CALL-UND.
The academics are really strong. The professors, they really challenge you to learn and to apply your knowledge.
I think there's many different opportunities in different places that students can go on and off campus.
School of Engineering Mines is kind of one close-knit community. Everybody's friendly. You're not just, you know, a name in the crowd or a number.
I've always wanted to do engineering. What we're learning here is just hands-on.
The department has been very good about acquiring the resources we need.
I think that through this project, I've gained a lot of the team working skills, leadership.
A campus that supports a wide range of degrees gives you a nice ability to round out your education in a variety of areas.
The word taxidermy is Greek for moving skin. Taxidermists do more than just preserve animals. They preserve memories as well. Today we spend a day in the life of a taxidermist.
Taxidermists can preserve a wild animal so that it will last for years. Jim Benson has been doing this for many years. When mounting an animal, it is first skinned and prepared. Eyes, ears, noses, and horns are mounted to a mannequin with clay to shape features and facial expressions. Jim mostly does fish, birds, and animals people hunt. Throughout his career, Jim has received some unusual requests. One from a farmer stands out in his mind.
He said, our cow gave birth to a two-headed calf. And he says, I've never seen anything like it. We have to have it mounted.
Jim does most of his work for state parks, museums, and schools and universities. He also opens his business up for field trips.
I enjoy seeing kids come in and they're just in awe when they see all these different animals that we otherwise would never see.
Jim recently won Best in Show for an African animal similar to this one in a championship. Jim can also make plastic replicas of fish. This fish is made from the real skin. This one, however, is a replica. Jim says replicas are good to use in order to preserve animals. Jerry Janorski works for Jim as a taxidermist. He says a lot of people have misconceptions about the occupation.
It's not all blood and guts like you would think. It's a lot of artwork and creativity.
The art of taxidermy is here to stay. But where technology will lead it, both taxidermists are excited to find out about. Reporting for Studio One, I'm Ibeke Carlson.
Jim does not work on pets. As a pet owner himself, he says he would not feel comfortable. There are taxidermists who do specialize in pets, though. The cost of getting a dog preserved is about $3,000. Matthew McConaughey stars in a new epic called U-571. A disabled German U-boat is stuck in the middle of the North Atlantic during World War II. The U.S. Navy comes up with a plan to board the Nazi sub in order to capture a secret communication device. This machine enabled Germans to communicate with their sub fleet and Navy. Jon Bon Jovi and Bill Paxton also star in this film. Matthew McConaughey plays a lieutenant whose life dream is to be captain of his own boat.
He's somebody I want next to me. If it all hits the fan and I'm in a ditch and I need someone there to survive with, I want Andrew Tyler with me.
The rain towers that were built for this epic were said to be the biggest ever built for a movie. Dino De Laurentiis directed U-571. He has directed more than 600 films throughout his lifetime. And now it's time to take a look at the events happening in your area.
We'll be right back.
Tax season can be a stressful time for some Americans. The Internal Revenue Service has made several changes to the income tax filing process. These changes were made in an attempt to make filing your taxes easier. Now that the filing deadline has passed, we wanted your thoughts if these changes have worked or what else could be done.
What did you think about doing your taxes this year?
I didn't think there were any problem. I didn't actually do them myself, so they were no big deal.
I guess it's always kind of a pain. Partly because you're never really sure if you've done everything absolutely right. But I guess, I'd be in favor of a flat tax. It'd make it a lot easier, I think. So.
It was very easy and very fun, and I enjoyed it a lot.
No problem, because we bring them in to somebody, and he has everything ready. We just have to put a stamp on it.
I take them to my tax preparer and take care of it, so no problem.
Taxes this year, they were a breeze. Did everything electronically, filed everything electronically. The only difference was it took 3 times as long to get the North Dakota return back as it did the federal return.
My dad did them for me.
To many people, the third Sunday of every month is like any other day. The East Grand Forks Rod and Gun Club like to start it out with a bang.
These people all have at least one thing in common. They all love guns. The East Grand Forks Rod and Gun Club started over 50 years ago and has grown rapidly since then. People who own guns have taken a lot of heat lately due to criminal activity with guns. Club President Roger Salter says this creates negative stereotypes.
I don't like to see it because there are a lot of good people that own guns and abide by all the rules, and the criminals aren't going to abide by the rules anyway. And it's sad to see, because the people that are enjoying the guns and the shooting sports are basically losing our rights for ownership of guns, and I don't like to see it happen.
The club is designed to improve accuracy and speed with a weapon. Members are timed with a device that picks up on every shot fired with a microphone. After a round, the time is recorded on a slip of paper. Competing, however, isn't what the club is all about.
The favorite part is the facility and being able to come out and do your shooting when you want to. And there's a lot of good friendships built here and a lot of camaraderie.
Members come from all over North Dakota and Minnesota. According to Brian Burkett, there are many types of people who participate.
We've got lawyers, doctors, computer people, mechanics, everything. I mean, farmers, you name it, I think there's somebody that's out here.
What members get out of the club is friendship and an opportunity to do what they love. I'm Scott Shelton, reporting for Studio One.
The Rod and Gun Club has a vast age group. The juniors are 10 to 12 years old, and the oldest members are in their 80s. Well, there's a certain type of rose that is increasing in popularity. Later in the show, we'll talk with a professional landscaper who will tell us why these roses are noted for their hardiness and minimum care. Plus, some musicians are involved in a lot more than just playing in a band. We'll see what life is like off the stage with Danzig. That's story plus news, sports, and the updated weather forecast in the next half hour of Studio One.
Let's take a first look at the principles of public relations.
And now we'll begin to use your knowledge from other courses.
The School of Law at the University of North Dakota is steeped in tradition. From the first graduating class, students today learn from the Modern Law Library and computer labs. Students write for the North Dakota Law Review, take part in moot court, and review court proceedings with video technology. Law and medical students compete in the annual Malpractice Bowl.
The size of our student body gives great access to their teachers, and our computer network allows us to access worldwide legal resources.
Look up the UND School of Law for more opportunities.
Are you a parent looking for child care? Do you know what good child care looks like? Do you provide child care and have questions? Does child care affect your business? Do you have employees who are concerned about child care? Doesn't every child deserve quality child care? Any questions? Call Child Care Resource and Referral.
The University of North Dakota's College of Business and Public Administration is nationally and internationally recognized as a center of excellence.
We actually created a business plan for this small retail store, which is now being used.
It's introducing me to technology that will be used in my business work environment.
For more information about the UND College of Business and Public Administration, phone 1-800-CALL-UND.
You're watching Studio One. News, weather, sports, and entertainment.
Welcome back to Studio One.
Thanks for tuning in today.
Well, I never knew this, but people who are anemic can have some really weird cravings.
Okay, and what is anemic?
Okay, anemic is when you are low on red blood count cells,
okay.
Or red cells, blood count. Some of the weird cravings that people have gotten are eating cardboard boxes, burnt matchsticks, and cigarette ash. Someone even licked the dust off of a nation blind. You can believe it. So I guess take your iron pills and don't get low on red.
So they turn into puppies. And they just chew on everything.
I guess. I don't know.
Coming up in the next 30 minutes on Studio One, we'll show you how technology is giving young children the chance to hear again.
And legendary rock artists such as Johnny Cash and Roy Orbison have worked with Glenn Danzig. He's known for his groundbreaking work in rock music. We interviewed this innovative musician.
Also, evergreens and shrubs are an ideal combination for effective landscaping. The contrast in color and texture blends to provide all-season interest and variety. Later, we'll talk with someone who can tell us more about an evergreen's year-round beauty.
All right.
But first, today's news with Kelly Franson.
Thanks, Rachel and Monty. A line of severe storms spawned at least four tornadoes in southeastern Kansas Wednesday night, destroying homes and causing minor injuries. One tornado struck a direct hit on Parsons, Kansas, a town of about 13,000 people. The storm tossed cars into the air, demolished about 10 houses, and flattened a carnival. It destroyed part of the police station and seriously damaged the fire department. Officials say serious injuries were prevented by turning on sirens before the storm hit, but more than 20 people did suffer minor injuries. Tornadoes are common to the region, but the impact of this one was worse than any in recent history. The Miami relatives of Elian Gonzalez have won a small victory in their battle to keep Elian in the U.S. A U.S. Court of Appeals ruled that Elian must remain in the U.S. until the court decides if he should get an asylum hearing. But the court ruling does not prevent the government from reuniting the boy with his father. Miami relatives are now willing to let Elian meet with his father, but lawyers for Juan Gonzalez says he will not agree to a meeting until he has custody of Elian. Some families are convinced that increased vaccinations caused their children to develop autism. Activists say the increasing number of children affected by autism could relate to the high number of vaccinations they receive. Congressman Dan Burton of Indiana is the chair of the House Government Reform Committee. Burton, whose grandson has autism, has called a hearing on the subject. But doctors and scientists are skeptical of any connection.
Vaccinations are given. And what happens is that autism develops kind of about the same time as a lot of the vaccines are given. And so I think there's never been any proven scientific evidence that vaccinations of any kind are related to autism.
Critics are calling for further investigation, but they still stress that vaccinations are important. People have been using honey for centuries to treat a wide range of medical problems, including wounds, burns, and scrapes. Now a company in Australia has begun marketing honey as a wound dressing. Dozens of studies have found that honey helps wounds by providing a protective barrier around them and killing the germs. Some unknown ingredients in honey reduce inflammation and speed the growth of healthy tissue. Studies so far have found no side effects other than a slight burning sensation when the honey is applied. Listening plays a key role in a child's development, but it can be hard to listen if you can't hear. With the help of technology, many people with profound hearing loss now have access to an auditory world. In the past, people with hearing loss had to depend on other senses to communicate and to learn. But technology is changing that. Devin Smart was born profoundly deaf. But with the help of a cochlear implant, he now has access to a world of sound.
The cochlear implant is a biomedical device that's surgically inserted into the inner ear called the cochlea that directly electrically stimulates the underlying auditory neural tissue and sends electrical stimulation directly to the auditory centers of the brain.
This makes sound available for people who cannot hear naturally. Devin's parents suspected something was wrong with his hearing when he was about 10 months old.
You know, it wasn't until he started being mobile that he kind of realized that he wasn't turning to the sound. So that's when he was identified.
At that time, cochlear implants were not given to children under 2, so Devin and his parents had to wait. Devin is now 4 years old chronologically. His hearing age is only 2. Devin receives speech therapy to help bridge the gap between his chronological and hearing ages.
We're working on his, mostly on his language skills, and so that's all of his vocabulary and concepts like colors and shapes and up and down.
The goal of post-implant therapy is to provide vocal stimulation. Clinicians are trained to focus on input rather than output. Parents are encouraged to continue the treatment at home by talking to their children as much as possible. In Devin's case, this is something his parents are very happy to do.
Happy!
Thanks to technology, Devin seems happy to be hearing and talking, too. Children are now able to receive cochlear implants at 12 months. Flexer says the sooner a person can hear, the better, because early years are crucial in development. That's the news for today. Back to Rachel and Monty.
Thanks, Kelly.
Well,
in stereo. Thanks, Kelly.
Well, I'm really curious to see what this weekend's forecast is going to look like. So let's go to Eric Svoboda at the Regional Weather Information Center for our weather. Eric?
Well, Monty and Rachel, we're looking at a very nice Easter forecast with very nice warm conditions. But first, let's take a look at those current conditions in the Grand Forks area. Temperature dropping a little bit, now at 60. That dew point's at 19. Wind is north-northeast at 12 miles an hour, and the pressure is still falling. Looking at our jet stream map, you can see cold air is trapped right over our area and to the north, but this pocket of warm air down to our south is keeping their temperatures warm. But as we move into Tuesday, you can see that cold air expands and just squishes that warm air into a small pocket in the southern part of Texas. Saturday's surface analysis shows a slight chance of rain for our area, probably 30-40%, but a better chance for rain off to our east and north as that low pressure and cold front push through. Tuesday, we're looking at a higher chance of rain in the early part of next week as this low pressure and cold front push through our area and cause all these cloudy skies for the northern Midwest. Your weekend's looking like this. Saturday, a high of 61, low of 42 with some mostly clear skies. And Sunday, a high of 64 with mostly clear skies. It's going to be a good day to go out and look for Easter eggs. Now, I thought I hid some in the studio, but maybe not. But Sunday's going to be some nice conditions to get out and look for some Easter eggs.
All right. Thanks, Eric. We've got some over here for you.
That'll be good.
Yeah,
well,
definitely.
We've also got some great sports stories coming up, and Brian Sean will supply us with that.
Thank you, Monty and Rachel. The success of an athlete is dependent on many factors. At one high school in North Dakota, the continued achievements of the girls' discus throwers have led many to believe that the program is the biggest influence in producing champions.
Brianna Reynolds knows what it takes to succeed. She is not only favored to win the North Dakota State Girls Discus Championship, but she is also ranked number one in the nation. Brianna's coach, Ryan Reynolds, says her success and the success of the Red River Track program are directly related to the ideals and methods that the program uses.
I think it's a success because a lot of repetition. I mean, we base the program more on repetition, get a lot of throws in, and working on technique over and over and over. You know, there's a good saying that, or a guy used to say, is 10,000 throws a year. That's our goal, 10,000 throws. We work on, be the best technicians in North Dakota. That's our main goal.
There are many strong points in the discus program.
Probably the repetition, the amount of throws we get in, and just the techniques we use, and the weight training, all the different types of trainings we do.
Due to repetition and technique, Red River High School in Grand Forks, North Dakota has produced 70 state champions in the last 20 years, many of them in discus. From a coaching standpoint, Reynolds says one of the most important parts of the program are drills.
All sorts of drills where we break apart the move, you know, working on like power positions and, you know, spinning the disc nice and getting good releases.
The discus squad has proven itself in the past and continues to show prosperity. In recent years, three throwers have gone to college on discus scholarships. With photographer Chris Hobden, I'm Rochelle Bolben, reporting for Studio One Sports.
With the help of the Red River Discus program, Reynolds and one of her teammates broke the all-time school record for the longest throw. They were both freshmen at the time. Now it's time for the answer of this week's Studio One Sports Trivia Question of the Week. This week's question, in Major League Baseball, which league has won more All-Star wins? The National League or the American League? The answer, the National League has 40 wins, the American League has 29 wins, and there was actually one tie in 1961 at Fenway Park in Boston because of a rainout. That's the sports for today. Monty and Rachel.
Thank you, Brian. Well, when building a house, it's important to consider landscaping. These aspects can soften the corners of a home or highlight focal points. A landscape designer will tell us how to plan the perfect yard.
Also, music, myth, and mystery combine to describe the creator of Danzig. The band has legendary status and has sold over 8 million records. Behind this band is Glenn Danzig himself, who is as unique as they come. We'll get a taste of his musical expression. That story's next on Studio One.
Are you a parent looking for childcare? Do you know what good childcare looks like? Do you provide childcare and have questions? Does childcare affect your business? Do you have employees who are concerned about childcare? Doesn't every child deserve quality childcare? Any questions? Call Child Care Resource and Referral.
The University of North Dakota has a rich history of retaining and graduating American Indian students. UND offers 28 American Indian programs, more than any other higher education institution in the U.S. The support services provided by Native American programs enhance student success. Native American programs offer tutoring, academic advising, and financial aid assistance, which makes UND a leader in Indian education. For more information, call 1-800-CALL-UND. That's 1-800-CALL-UND.
University of North Dakota's College of Business and Public Administration is nationally and internationally recognized as a center of excellence.
They motivate me by keeping me interested in the class, having it more interactive.
Before they can get accredited, they have to meet certain requirements, and it's a good school.
For more information about the UND College of Business and Public Administration, phone 1-800-CALL-UND. The School of Law at the University of North Dakota is steeped in tradition. From the first graduating class, students today learn from the Modern Law Library and computer labs. Students write for the North Dakota Law Review, take part in moot court, and review court proceedings with video technology. Law and medical students compete in the annual Malpractice Bowl.
The size of our student body gives great access to their teachers, and our computer network allows us to access worldwide legal resources.
Look up the UND School of Law for more opportunities.
You're watching Studio One from the University of North Dakota. In our studio audience today, we have students from Glenburn, Kitson Central, and Montevideo High Schools, and other family and friends. Thank you for coming today. Well, with his rebellious attitude and powerful image, Glenn Danzig is a controversial artist that is shrouded in myth and mystery. Nonetheless, Danzig is a musician with many creative expressions.
Decades of intense rock and roll, Glenn Danzig has set a profound and permanent mark on music. In 1977, Danzig formed the Misfits, a punk rock group that attained a cult following and legendary status. Glenn Danzig left the Misfits and went on to Samhain. He then formed Danzig in 1987, resulting in more than 8 million records sold. Danzig says rebellion has always been at the heart of his music, in the true spirit of real rock and roll. He says these themes revealed the core of his music and message.
Power, strength, celebration of life, all the good and bad things about it, the way the world is, the way it always will be, and dealing with all those different things.
Danzig is also very interested in comics and founded the publishing company Verotic in 1994. Verotic is an alternative line of comic books with erotic and action-packed content for mature readers. Danzig has also been successful as an actor,
and has directed several of his own music videos. Danzig says he also wants to direct movies. Music is still Danzig's passion, and he has explored many genres. A common trait of his bands is that their music is considered innovative and groundbreaking. Danzig says it was always his goal to push the limits with original music that set new standards for others to follow.
I mean, one of the things I wanted to do, and I've said it right from the beginning of any of the bands, like Mr. Samhain, was I wanted the music to last. And it has.
Danzig says his music has helped change the face of rock music forever. He still has a strong desire to change many things in the music industry, especially what he calls the sellout ethic in the business and the lack of integrity among many artists. He says many bands surrender to the whims of the record labels instead of staying true to themselves and their music. Danzig says creative control and artistic freedom are more crucial to him than commercial success. His musical contributions have shown they can stand the test of time and continue to inspire many other artists.
Danzig is just unbelievable. He's charismatic. He's got unbelievable stage presence. You know, we can learn a lot from what he does, definitely.
Danzig's hard edge and intensity invokes unease in some people. But Danzig is a multi-faced artist, and appearances can be deceptive. Guitarist Todd Youth says Danzig shouldn't be judged at face value and describes him as having a lighter side also.
Funny. He's just a funny dude, man. He's got great stories, and he's always cracking me up. Everybody's always got this image of him as, like, you know, this dark, scary guy, but he's just mad cool. He's funny.
Youth says he grew up listening to Danzig's music and that playing with him is an honor and a dream come true.
You know, I've always been a big Danzig fan. You know, I got the call, you know, you want to be in the band. I was just like, yeah, let's go.
After more than 20 years of uncompromising rock and roll, Danzig has built himself a solid fan base. They're now waiting to see a show that is considered to be one of the most intense of its kind.
Danzig says playing live is the greatest aspect of making music and is where his true passion lies. He also says working with such legends as Roy Orbison and Johnny Cash are some of the highlights of his career.
And just being able to, you know, write a song for somebody like Roy Orbison or Johnny Cash, and then they'll hear it and they'll say, yeah, I like the song, I'm gonna do it. That's pretty wild.
Danzig has no intentions of calling it quits, and there's undoubtedly new highlights to come in the years ahead. With photographer Harald Svarstad, I am Christian Kjelsberg, reporting for Studio One.
Danzig says he will begin working on his first movie, Venus Domina, later this summer. This movie is based on a comic book character he publishes through Verotic. Some things to consider when planning to landscape a yard are animals, children, and outdoor entertaining. Our next guest is going to talk about the variety one can use to create a terrific garden. Stay with us.
The University of North Dakota's Division of Continuing Education can help you learn throughout your lifetime. Begin or continue your education through correspondence study, extended degree programs, and extension courses. For your personal or professional growth, we offer conferences as well as courses in dietary management and real estate.
We invite you to contact us at the Division of Continuing Education to discuss your learning opportunities.
Call us or look us up on the World Wide Web.
School of Engineering Mines is, we're kind of one close-knit community. Everybody's friendly. You're not just, you know, a name in the crowd or a number.
I've always wanted to do engineering. What we're learning here is just hands-on.
The department has been very good about acquiring the resources we need.
I think that through this project I've gained a lot of the team working skills, leadership.
A campus that supports a wide range of degrees gives you a nice ability to round out your education in a variety of areas.
The academics are really strong. The professors, they really challenge you
to learn and to apply your knowledge.
I think there's many different opportunities in different places that students can go on and off campus.
The University of North Dakota's College of Business and Public Administration is nationally and internationally recognized as a center of excellence.
We actually created a business plan for this small retail store, which is now being used.
It's introducing me to technology that'll be used in my business work environment.
For more information about the UND College of Business and Public Administration, phone 1-800-CALL-UND.
Professional landscaping can add up to 10% to the value of your home. A well-placed shrub or evergreen will provide shade in the summer and protection from cold winter winds. Landscape designer Chip Shea joins us to tell us how we can use plants and trees effectively. Thanks for joining us today, Chip.
Thank you for having me, Rachel.
How did you get started in landscaping?
Well, I guess my parents started a business here in town, Tim Shea's Nursery and Landscaping, back in 1979. And as a kid, I guess I looked at it as a job, you know, within the family. And as I started getting more into it, I really started enjoying what I was doing and decided to take into, you know, some college courses into it and really got into, you know, helping people achieve their landscape dreams, I guess, with what I can design for them.
Okay, so you've been doing this for a while.
Yeah, quite a while.
Yeah. When do people need to start planning their landscape?
Well, I guess with anything, it's good to have a good plan going into, you know, any project that you're trying to tackle. As with landscaping, it really does, you know, mean a lot to have a good plan. A lot of people will try and maybe haphazardly just throw in plants here and there, but it is, you know, more beneficial to them if they would meet with somebody like myself that could help them come up with a plan. And I guess if you're thinking about doing any landscape project at all, it is better to meet with somebody that may be able to help you do that a little bit better.
Okay. If people are, like, buying a new home, is that a good time, like, right away to ask about landscaping, or when should that be done?
Most definitely. I guess some people, when they are building a home, you know, you do have to compile bids and get prices in order to get a home built. And a lot of people will figure into their mortgage, you know, the landscaping that they want to put into their home. And it is a very important part of a new home because it is really the first thing that you do see when you drive up to a new home. I guess for me to think about it, you know, for somebody that's going to be building a brand new beautiful home, it only makes sense to try and make your landscaping just as beautiful as the home that you're building.
Okay. Well, are there any techniques that you need to follow? I noticed that you provided a nice computer landscape layout. If the cameras can get that, maybe I'll hold it out here if you want to explain it a little bit.
Yeah, you know, there's a lot of different things you need to consider when you go about doing a design. One of the main things that you want to try and accomplish is making your house fit to the property that you have and working in plants that will fit to this, you know, to the area that you've got. You want to be sure you space things out enough so that they do have room to mature in order to, you know, to gain a nice landscape in the future. You don't want to ever plant things too close, whether it be to the house or to another plant. But you really want to get a good plan that will, you know, in time grow to be what you expect it to be.
Okay, now speaking in terms of, like, proximity and stuff to the house, you also talked a little bit about framing, and we have a picture of that too if you want to explain that.
Yeah, well, it's, you know, again, it's good to meet with somebody that can kind of explain techniques to you. This is one example of how you can use framing. You know, every house or every structure usually has a lot of straight lines, and you know, with your landscaping, you want to create curves on the ground, and that what that does is it takes away the hardness of a structure, and it really adds a lot of, you know, a lot of curves and dimension to a property. But it really softens things, and by, you know, covering up right angles with certain plants, especially with the use of evergreens for winter landscape, also to keep that in mind. But it's just good to get, you know, good plants in the right spots to do the right things that you're looking to do.
Okay. Now you also talked a little bit about focal points, and we've got an actual evergreen tree over here.
Right. Well, I brought with me today this plant here. It's called a globe blue spruce, and it's a tree form of that. And this is one example of how you can create a focal point within a garden or within a landscape in the front of a house. You can plant this in an area that will be seen, and by looking at this plant, it really is something that catches your eye. And then from that point, you can do plantings underneath it to kind of contrast with the colors, you know, and really bring the blue in, tie in with reds. But it's really kind of an art form and getting the right plants and the right flowers to bloom at the right time and mixing with things to really catch your eye.
Okay. Now, how does the cost work? I know, or can you give us kind of a range of like the basic to the more elaborate? Or?
Well, it's kind of hard to really put a price tag on any, you know, any certain design or any, you know, multiple designs. It's better to, you know, meet with somebody, get a plan drawn, and then from that point, you know, I would meet with somebody and see what their needs are, what their wants are, and from there I can get them an exact price. And again, it, you know, like you said, it varies with how, you know, how substantial of a project you're looking at doing, you know, from just redoing the front of an existing landscape or, you know, from a brand new house. There's going to be quite a variety of costs that you would consider.
Okay, real quickly, why don't you tell me a little bit about the flowers you've got up here?
Sure, well, I guess I just brought these with today just to kind of, you know, show how using variety in the landscape can really, you know, add a lot of color to what you're trying to accomplish. I've brought with some sunblaze roses, and that's what these are here. Roses are really a hot thing right now, I guess shrub roses in particular, due to the fact that they will give you real nice rose flower, and they're a lot easier to take care of than say your old-fashioned type roses. So I guess for more of the low-maintenance type gardener, that would be a real nice plant to select.
Okay, well, these are my favorite. Why don't you tell me a little bit about this real quick?
Well, those, I guess as most people might be able to tell what they are, that is a bleeding heart, and that is really more of an old-fashioned type plant that you might see in your grandma's garden. But it has been around for a long time, and I guess I brought that with just to show a more of a common plant that people might be able to associate with.
Okay, so, I really like that one.
Yeah.
Well, thanks so much for joining us today, Chip. It was a pleasure, and I hope people can use this as they're building their own home and designing their own layout.
You're welcome. Thank you for having me.
Mm-hmm. You're watching Studio One from the University of North Dakota. We'll be right back after this.
The first summer of the new millennium will be an exciting time at the University of North Dakota. Summer Session 2000 brings you undergraduate and graduate level programs. Summer Session can help you graduate early or on time. Raise your GPA while taking shorter courses with fewer classmates. Financial aid is available for those who qualify. Classes start in May and June. Registration begins April 10th. Call 1-800-CALL-UND for details. That's 1-800-CALL-UND.
Valor Insurance partners with you in protecting what matters most. For more than 50 years, Valor has built its reputation on its people, its clients, and a commitment to VIP service. Valor Insurance, Fargo, Bismarck, Grand Forks. Valor Insurance understands that the strength of its people is its greatest asset. People that tailor insurance protection that meets your needs. That's the key to VIP service. Valor Insurance, Fargo, Bismarck, Grand Forks.
Columbia Mall in Grand Forks has been a cornerstone of the Grand Forks economy for over 20 years. Meet me at Columbia is a slogan that has seen friends and neighbors gathering at Columbia Mall. Three main anchors with 80 specialty stores and shops greets customers daily, Monday through Sunday, featuring the very latest in goods and services at the most competitive prices. Shop Target, JCPenney, and Dayton's, along with the specialty stores in climate-controlled comfort, no matter what the season. A continuing leader and community cornerstone is Columbia Mall, Grand Forks.
At Little Caesars, we only use vine-ripened tomatoes, a blend of 100% real cheese, dough made fresh each day. For 40 years, every Little Caesars pizza has been made this way, with a taste that makes you want to savor each and every bite. That is, if you like that sort of thing.
Dad!
Every Tuesday is Hot and Ready Tuesday at Little Caesars. Pick up a medium cheese or pepperoni pizza for only $4, guaranteed to be hot and ready in 5 minutes, or it's free every Tuesday. Pizza, pizza.
Tune in next week on Studio One. We'll take a close look at the ancient art of tattooing. Plus, we'll give you the rundown on what's happening in entertainment and news.
Well, did Chip bring all of those plants in one vehicle?
He did, a big pickup, so we'll have to help him load it up.
He couldn't put it in a Chevette anyway.
Yeah.
Well, we're going to leave you now with some pictures from the Humane Society, courtesy of photographer Andrea Cota. From all of us here at Studio One, have a great week.